everyone. I am Janet Gallimore, the Executive Director of the Idaho State Historical Society. I'm welcoming you to the Disturbing Justice exhibition at the Old Idaho Pen, the newest of our portfolio of exhibitions at the Idaho State Historical Society. We are an extraordinary system of cultural and historic resources made up, of course, the Old Pen, the Idaho State Archives, the State Museum, the State Historic Preservation Office, and statewide historic sites. And we preserve and promote Idaho's history for you. So why are we here today? The Old Idaho Penitentiary is a unique place in American history. And it is a place that deals with social justice. And the Disturbing Justice exhibition deals with those challenging stories over time that have occurred here at the Old Idaho Penitentiary. So I think one of the important things to remember is this is really the place where these things happened. And we try as best as we can to tell the story of history through the lens of humanity and through the lens of the people who lived here and had to endure a great amount of difficulty in their life, but hopefully at some point they were released from that difficulty. We want to thank many people for this great exhibition. Of course, the Boise City Arts and History Department for their grant support, Boise State for their support of photography. But most of all, I want to make a big call out to the National Endowment for the Humanities, who supported this exhibition and our staff in the amount of $141,000 through CARES Act funding that came about through helping to support cultural organizations through COVID-19. We are so very grateful for the support of the National Endowment for the Humanities. I also want to thank the Foundation for Idaho History for their support, and also make a big call out to our staff at the Old Idaho Penitentiary for their amazing scholarship and devotion to their work. And in fact, this exhibit was touched by every single department of our agency. So it was a team effort, as we always strive to do during difficult times as well as challenging times. Also, please check out our website and you can learn more about virtual programming that will help to support your understanding of the Old Idaho Penitentiary and the Idaho State Historical Society and all of the programs that we do on behalf of all Idahoans. And in particular, Behind Gray Walls, our great podcast that really talks in depth about the stories of the people who lived here and served in the Old Idaho Penitentiary. Thank you so much for your support, and we look forward to seeing you at Disturbing Justice and at all future ISHS programs. Thank you.
Hi, and welcome to the Old Idaho Penitentiary's opening of Disturbing Justice. We hope you have a safe and secure evening. It's been a year of detailed planning going into this exhibit. We're very excited to bring it to you and to everyone. I continue Jan's thanks with all our wonderful partners at the city, the university, and of course, the National Endowment for the Humanities. Also, this was an agency-wide collaboration. All of our Idaho State Historical partners helped with that. The work groups with the SHPO office helped us with the changes that we made inside the building and signs that we put outside the building. Of course, the Idaho State Archives is home to all those wonderful inmate records, those rich documents and photographs that we have that make the story so much more compelling. Of course, our friends at the Idaho State Museum lent us a wonderful graphic designer, Brian Rich, who brought this exhibit to life for us. We also want to thank, of course, Alan Gladfelter, our artist, who put the art and the narrative of that together. It was very important to us when we put this exhibit together to make sure that this had a statewide impact, because of course the story of the Idaho State Penitentiary is the story of justice in Idaho and the state of corrections in Idaho throughout the state. And so we are making sure that we've got digital content to bring you, sneak peeks at those at the exhibit itself, and of course teacher resources, so that this story, though it lives here and it's best in the place and context of this site, is also available to everyone. Another part of that is making sure that we have interactives on site. And so we will ask people critical questions about the exhibit, about social justice in Idaho, about social justice in our region and our nation. And those will be interactive components just to the side where the building was burned down in the 1971 riot. So everything connects. It was important for us to make sure that history, of course, though it happened in the past, it brought us to where we are today. And we wanted to make sure that that historic narrative was told in a compelling way, an interesting way, using art, using history, and also using multiple perspectives. Because this isn't just the story of inmates, and it isn't just the story of the guards. It's all of their stories combined, and it's the story of all Idahoans and what is important to us. I also would be remiss if I didn't thank our partners at the Idaho Department of Corrections, who help us stay connected to the current state of affairs, as well as all those former inmates and guards who have come forward once they've heard about this, whether it be through our podcast or just coming to visit us. Those stories are so important to us, and we ask you to continue to give those to us so we continue to tell the story of Idaho. Of course, as I mentioned, this did happen during the pandemic. And though we were isolated in many ways, all that did was bring to the forefront the importance of what we were doing and keeping people and continuing to stay connected to our history. And then, of course, all the issues of social justice that came up during the pandemic with Black Lives Matters, other issues of the police force, whether all these social justice issues connected to Idaho, and what was the value and what was the importance. And what we found is that what we were doing was really important, tell a complete story, and how all of those things that are happening now connect directly back to what was happening here in all these riots and disturbances. So I thank you for coming out tonight, and I thank you for enjoying and really thinking about the things that we brought forward in Disturbing Justice. Thank you.